Hello everyone, my name is Dylan Craig, and today I'm doing a video. This is Dylan Craig Transfer Soul episode 3. Yay, I'm finally doing a series from Ireland, two fucking episodes. This is Dylan Craig Transfer Soul episode 3. There's some big transfers here. There's actually two rumours, but I think they will eventually turn into real transfers. Let's fucking get into this. First transfer. Juan Cuadrado, for 20 million from Chelsea to Juve permanently after his 2-year loan spell. Cuadrado is definitely more suited to Juve than Chelsea, in my opinion. And he's obviously first, and he's obviously done fucking class at Juve now. And I'm very proud. I don't know why I'm saying that, but I'm happy that he's finally getting a career that he deserves, because Juve. And I'm finally getting happy that he's getting a career that, you know, he's a quality footballer, and he's finally getting a career that he deserves. Good player. I think it's really good for Chelsea doing the money and 20 million for someone that, you know, most Premier League fans have forgotten about, so. And Juan Cuadrado could definitely go on and help Juventus maybe win the Champions League someday, and obviously go on and win as many Scudettos as he fucking wants, because that's the Italian league for you. You know, and that's for my Inter Milan, AC Milan in this video become fucking giants like they used to be, then Juve's gonna win the Scudetto every year. So yeah, Juan Cuadrado for 20 million from Chelsea to Juve. Good signing. Next one, this only really happened a couple days ago, same as the Cuadrado one. Pablo Zabaleta, obviously he has left Man City, I think, now. Going from Man City to West Ham on a free, I'm guessing on a free. I think that's a good transfer, because, you know, I think it's good for Zabaleta, you know, maybe finish off his career at a top level, at a top BPL team, and, called West Ham a top BPL team, they're not really. Or, you know, finish a mediocre BPL team that he'll definitely get game time at. I think that's good form. I think that's really, really class form. I think that's good form. I think that this was a good format to get rid of dead weight. Who's ever going to start? Like Zabaleta. I still don't think any sense to sign a right back and left back. Clichy and Sanya are old as fuck. And B, they're really getting on. Got to read about him rebuilding Man City. He needs more younger quality footballers. You know? So I think he's the definitely like there's a Bruno, like Bruno Henriques, who's been really well for Munich. And Jose Gaya, who's playing very well for Valencia. So but God knows, maybe Guardiola likes old people. Maybe Guardiola likes old sweaty man. Oh god, that's gonna make me sound like weirdo. Next transfer, Jermaine Defoe for free from Sunderland to Bournemouth. I can see this happening. Defoe didn't want to stay there. I don't know if he didn't see it. Jermaine Defoe is too good of a striker to be staying at a Championship team, for fuck's sake. I think he's definitely quarter. He's definitely quarter. I think Defoe deserves to be in the Premier League, not in Championship or some specific club like Sunderland. I think Bournemouth also do really well with him, and Callum Wilson or Joshua King up front. Joshua King has obviously been fucking class this year. I think that's a good sign for Sunderland, and also a fucking class sign for Bournemouth. No, sorry, that's a horrible loss for Sunderland, who I now think would do fucking shit in Championship. They won't get relegated, but they'll do it Aston Villa and Minifest mid table. Yeah. Next transfer is actually a forced. I have a rumour about this. Apparently, Gylfi Sigurdsson from Swansea going to Everton for 25 million. I can see that. I don't know. I actually can't see that happening, because Gylfi Sigurdsson is class. Thanks. Thanks, boom. That's awkward. Where they sang at me while I'm recording a YouTube video. Yeah, I think Gylfi Sigurdsson is good. I can see him going to 20 million, but I don't think Swansea should let him go, because he's class. If Swansea do let him go, that'd be really stupid of them. So yeah, I don't think Swansea's let him go, but I actually can't see that happening. I think we'll say that's a 1 out of 5 happening. I can't see that happening. No. Next one is only been recently announced, confirmed. Yuri Tielemans going from Anderlecht to Monaco for 20 million. That's fucking class. Tielemans is one of, or maybe even the best, young midfielder in the world right now. Tielemans is absolutely class. Tielemans is a top Notts footballer who, you know, obviously in the past few years has shown that he's an absolute class act and that he is one of the best young players in the world. And now that Monaco's gone, Monaco will definitely retain that Ligue 1 title next year. And fuck it, the midterm and summer season. Although, don't forget, balance music is Tielemans is class. Tielemans is one of the best young players in the world. I think that's class for Tielemans to more post his career and just not sustain in, you know, the Belgian league, where it's an easy formula. So yeah, that's class for Monaco. Horrible fan of that. Horrible loss fan of that. And then next and final transfer, Matteo Masaccio. From undisclosed place, for Villarreal at AC Milan. AC Milan are becoming good again! Yay! That's still shit. Yeah, you won the fucking something Italian Cup this year, but still. That'll take a long time for her. But yeah, take a long time for AC Milan to become classic again. But this is a big step. Wait. I told Matteo Masaccio is a good centre back. When I saw him play against Liverpool in the Europa League semi final, he's class. He's a good player. I think that's definitely a good signing for AC Milan and a bad loss for Villarreal. And I saw him play. He's played really well, and he's really good at holding the ball up, and he's really good defending, and really good. Really good box to box. But he's just really good. Versatile centre back, he's a really good player, and I think AC Milan now need that. Now that they know Roman Gnoli, Matsumasaki can make a good bounce up him. So yeah, good signs. Hey, John, that has been the Dim and Greg Transfer Show episode 3. Hope you enjoyed the video. I did. I'll see you on the dark side. Peace.